السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. حياكم الله. Dear brothers, sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us, يا رب, our salah, siyam, دعاء, ذكر, قراءة القرآن الكريم, all the عبادات in this blessed month, the month of Ramadan. As you know, tonight is the night of 21st of Ramadan. Could be ليلة القدر, الله أعلم. We must be sincere more and make zikr more. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more for the khayr of the dunya and the akhirah. Ameen ya Rabbi alameen. Our example tonight, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال, ما الدنيا في الآخرة إلا كما يدخل أحدكم إصبعه في اليم فلينظر بما ترجع. He said the example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said the example of the dunya comparing with the akhirah. If you compare the dunya with the akhirah, like exactly one of you, he put his finger in the ocean or into the ocean like that. And look what you're going to return back with. With what? With nothing. Whatever that wetting, subhanAllah, in your finger from the ocean, this is the dunya comparing with al-akhirah. Al-akhirah, consider it like this ocean. Whatever you take, this is the dunya, nothing. Nothing, the dunya is nothing if you try to compare it with al-akhirah. Anybody working just for his dunya and he forgot al-akhirah, excuse me with this lafz in Arabic, he is ghabi. Ghabi. Ghabi means stupid. If somebody is just became busy, he been occupied too much with dunya, it is not haram if you follow the rules of Allah. But if you cancel about X in the akhirah and just you focus on the dunya and you make it your mission, that person is very stupid and ghabi. If you have wisdom, you're wise. If you are Hakim, if you focus and your heart still working and your Fuad, the Fuad means what? What's the difference between Fuad and the heart in the Quran? Qalb. Qalb is your heart. El Fuad is the lub of your heart. Lub means the core of your heart. This is your Fuad. Inna as-sam'a wal-basara wal-fu'ada kullu ulaika kana 'anhu mas'ul. ونقلب أفئدتهم سبحان الله. فالفؤاد is responsible for your feelings, but القلب for your إدراك, for everything, the rest of everything. That's why if your قلب is pure and سليم, healthy, don't worry, you're good. If your قلب, is خربان, you're in big trouble. فالدنيا دار من لا دار له ولها يسعى من لا عقل له. يا سبحان الله. الدنيا is a home of somebody has no home, has no house. It's a house if somebody has no house. He's in the middle of nowhere. And the one is working too much for الدنيا, he has no brain. He's خربان. Loser. خربان. He's going to in different direction. ولها يعمل أو يسعى, the one is working for it too much. من لا عقل له, somebody has no brain. He's not wise. If he's not wise, he will be stupid. And Allah told Rasulullah, and this message for us. وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. ورش, recited like this. حفص, وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. The end, the meaning of this ayah, Surah Al-Duha, the end of everything, the results of everything, O Muhammad, always will be better than the beginning of it to you. All the results will be good in your side, O Muhammad, in general. But al-akhirah means the dunya, al-akhirah also, the hereafter, after life, better than al-awla, dunya, O Muhammad. Subhanallah, ya jama'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never, He will never deprive us from anything. Even your desire, والله you can do whatever you want but in halal. You eat, you drink, those who are the sinners, they are eating and drinking too. But they are doing something haram, you're doing it halal. They are sleep with women, excuse me, يعني أقولها كده بالفلاحي. They are making adultery, you are, she's your wife, in halal. The same desire. Allah will never stop you from getting your desire and he never deprive you from anything. But just follow his order, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I hate this word. Somebody's telling you somebody ghani and somebody faqir. I was like, yeah, he's ghani, he's rich, has a lot of money. Oh yeah, he's poor, he has no money. For me, there is no difference. Do you know why? Because all of us, the richest person in the world and the poorest person in the world, our stomach, all of us, miyut. Our stomach what? Miyut. Do you know what does it mean? If you give your stomach full beans, salat barakat, beans or meat, your stomach will never talk to you, will never cry to you. Did you hear the sound or the voice of your stomach? No. تحط لها حتى طوب مش هتقول لك لا. Even if you put stone, dirt in your stomach, she will never cry. Just fill it with anything. Fill it with what? Gas. The best type of gas or the lowest type of gas. It's gonna work. Meat, full beans, just a piece of bread, some water, it will be okay. خلاص, the main thing, fill it. Your stomach will never cry to you. It's a mute. فدون تل مي بقى ايه, poor and faqir and rich and somebody has money. يا أخي والله, maybe you're eating, enjoying your food more than him. Maybe he has problem in his stomach. Has a lot of money, but he cannot eat everything because he has cancer in his stomach. I remember the story of that Egyptian actor, 1960s, Anwar Waqdi. That man, he was very poor in the beginning of his life. They told him, what about if Allah give you Egyptian million, 1 million Egyptian pound? The pound during the time, it was $5. During the time of King Farouk. One pound, Egyptian pound was $5. If Allah give you 1 million Egyptian pound, what are you gonna do? He said, oh, I will be the happiest person there. He said, what about if you become sick? He said, I will spend half of it to the doctor and then I will enjoy the rest. Allah give him, after he get millions, Allah give him what? Cancer in his stomach. He used to give food to the people and they used to eat and he was looking at them like this. He cannot eat. See? فيا جماعة, money is nothing. Dunya is nothing. Dirt above dirt. The real happiness is if you connect yourself to Allah, if you get the love of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the one who give wealth. Allah the one who give health. Allah the one who can give you, he can make you smart and wisdom, give you wisdom. Allah the one who give you children. Subhanallah. Too many people, they share with you this. Somebody smart and he has no deen. He has no religion. Did I tell you in Louisiana when I was visiting that hospital, the head of the department of the premature kids, those who have been born early, he was a big doctor from India. He's the head of the department, professor. I asked that Egyptian Kharbani was doctor there. I asked him, who's do you know that man? He talked about him to me. I found him, I asked him about his deen. Is he a Muslim? If he told me he's Muslim, I will be the happiest person in the world. Because I love Muslims to be in power, to have education, to be in very high positions, and this is Islam. He told me he's Hindu. Yani his cow, his God is cow, whatever. I was very sad. I said, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Allah gave him knowledge of dunya, but he has nothing for al-akhirah. May Allah get him. But this is what I said. People, they are sharing this wealth, health, children, everything, wisdom, whatever. But if Allah give you tranquility, you are the one. Thank you, Mr. Muslim. If Allah give you the tranquility, sakina, even if you don't have any money, that's it. You got everything. الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling us in too many ayat in the Quran, the smart person, the one which is Allah in his life, in his heart. This is the smart person. Wallahi, jama'ah. He said, إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ. He said, من كان يريد العاجلة عجلنا له فيها ما نشاء لمن نريد ثم جعلنا له جهنم يصلاها مذموما مدحورا ومن أراد الآخرة وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن فأولئك كان سعيهم مشكورا. إيه what is this? This ayat is a title itself. You can put it banner like this for your life. Don't miss it. I will read from my translation. Whoever desires the immediate enjoyment of this world, we grant him what he will, what we will, for whom we like. Then, in the hereafter, we will assign him hellfire. I'm telling you, that one, just his mission, dunya. Rabbi, stupid, he's not wise. He will burn in the hellfire, disgraced and rejected away from the mercy of Allah because of his love to this world and his the denial of the hereafter. Subhanallah. Look, I explained, alhamdulillah, the ayah. I give the explanation already. I put it because of his love to this dunya. You see, in a translation, they said because he immediate dunya and we gave him al-akhira, hellfire, and that's it. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ And whoever, now second person, you choose your way now. And whoever desires the reward of Allah in the hereafter and strives وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا سَعْي بِنُ الصَّفَى وَالْمَرْوَى سَعَى, work, run, move, do something, huh? And strives for it as due. And being obedient to Allah with belief in Allah's oneness, then the effort of such people will be appreciated and their good deeds will be accepted and be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The point here is, do not love dunya too much. The point here is, you want to get al-akhirah? Strive more, work hard for it. Sa'a laha sa'yaha. Do not just sit, yalla alhamdulillah brother. Allah ghafoor raheem, ya'am. Ya'am, I'll make you say, ya'am, menta. Oh. If you go to Jannah, please take me with you. Brother, come pray. If Allah guide me, I will come, brother. Again, you pray, Allah will guide you. Work, you will get it. Jannah is not free. Wallahi. Jannah is not free. Jannah is not free, right? Jannah is not free, jama'ah. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَا. You have to strive, you have to work. Am I right, Nani Kabir? Jazakallah khair. Okay. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just in this hadith, he want to show you the value of Allah, dunya. Once Rasulullah, who is the Sahaba, was passing by a deadly, filthy goat. And its ears short, a sack. Yani its ears what? Very short. Yani dead. Filthy, worms working in it, that body of the goat. And what else? And its ears what? Very short too, like this. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Sahaba, who wanna buy this from me with $2 yani. And the Sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, if it is still alive, even that $2 or $2 is too much for it. Because its ears is very sick, it's bad. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is a dunya. لا تساوي عند الله جناح بعوض. The wing of a mosquito, this is even the dunya has no value of Allah in the sight of Allah like the wing of a mosquito. ولو كانت تساوي even if the dunya will be equal to the wing of a mosquito in the sight of Allah, he said ما سقى كافرا منها شربة ماء. He will not give those who disbelieve in him, سبحان الله, sip of water like this, شربة ماء. This is what رسول الله said. يا جماعة, الدنيا has no value in the sight of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That's why Allah said in the Quran, too many ayat, وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Indeed, the hereafter, the afterlife, it is the real life if you really know. Dunya is nothing. رسول الله being offered by Allah سبحانه وتعالى to make the mountains of Mecca gold for him. رسول الله refused, صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, no. Do you want to be king and Nabi like Dawood and Sulaiman? Do you want to live forever? He said, no, no. Do you want me to make the mountains of Mecca gold for you? He said, no, no, no. I want to just live like a abd, a slave, servant. If you satisfy me, I eat food, I will be grateful to you. Alhamdulillah, Ya Rab. If I will be hungry, I will ask you for food. I want to live like this. And he used to say, Allahumma ahshurni fi zumrat al-masakeen. Oh Allah, admit me in Jannah with the poor people, the poor of the mu'mineen, masakeen. I don't want to be with the rich people. This is the humbleness of your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's read this ayah, then I will finish with that story because of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Al-Kahf, we read it every Friday, tomorrow. Verse number 45, Allah said, وَاضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا إِنْ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ فَأَصْبَحَ هَشِيمًا تَذْرُوهُ الرِّيَاحُ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. يا سلام. Look to this ayah. Another message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, O Muhammad, put forward to the mankind, especially the arrogant among them, the example of this worldly life, of this dunya. It is like water, and I explained that before. Water cannot stay in its condition all the time. If you leave it sometimes outside, will gone. Water like that. We send down from the sky, and the vegetation of the earth mingles with it, اختلط, mixed, and becomes green and fresh. But later, it becomes dry and in broken pieces, which the wind scatters. And Allah is powerful over everything. This is the example of a dunya. Exactly, when I give you that vegetation, when they mingles with the water, you see them green, fresh, growing. In the end, what can happen? Became old, yellow, little by little, yellow, yellow, yellow. And then these leaves will be what? Dry, 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 and then will die. Yeah. This is you and me. صح حجي؟ طيب. We'll finish with this story about the hadith which we said it today. Rasulullah said, the example of dunya comparing with al-akhirah, like one of you, he put his finger in the ocean and look what he get, nothing. This is dunya comparing with al-akhirah. We'll finish with this story. Rasulullah in the two journeys, al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, Allah showed him الدنيا like امرأة شمطاء, like an old ugly woman. Old ugly woman. And she called Rasulullah. She had too many adornments. And Rasulullah was passing and she was in the side. Dunya, like example of dunya, like old ugly lady. And she was trying to attract Rasulullah. Hi, Muhammad. Amir. Come on. Huh? Sah? Yes. The women. She was teasing him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Huh? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not even look at it. Ugly. Filthy. Bad. This is dunya. Why even I have to care about it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she tried to attract him. I want to live like a slave. I am in this dunya like traveler passing by in the desert. Gharib, stranger. This is what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We make it dunya like our dar, our qarar. We'll finish with this story. I think some of you, you know that story. Isa alayhi salam, Jesus alayhi salam. He used to live in Palestine. Palestine. He used to live where? Palestine. Yes, Palestine. He used to live in Palestine. And he used to go and make da'wah, and make da'wah between the villages. One time he took he had 2 pieces of bread, and he found one Israeli man in his way, and he said, my brother, I said, where are you going, Jesus? He said, I'm going to call people to Allah in this village. I'm going, yani. He had no house in the dunya, Sayyidina Isa. Yani, that's it, simple. And he said, can I come with you? I said, please, come. I said, what do you have? I said, I have 1 piece of bread. I said, I have to keep the 3 of them with you. Sayyidina Isa asked him to keep 3 pieces of bread with him. When we get hungry, we sit and we eat. And they went for da'wah. In the middle of the way, they found a little tree, and they said, let's take some rest. How many pieces of bread you have? He said, I just have 2. He said, man, I give you 2, and you had 2. 1. You have 3. He said, no, I just have 2. And Sayyidina Isa, as you know, Allah gave him too many miracles, right? He used to bring the dead people alive by the permission of Allah. He used to make some miracles. Allah told us by the permission of Allah. He was a prophet. And subhanAllah, he saw like a small deer running, deer, gazala. And he called the deer and he slaughtered it. He barbecued it, fixed it. They ate, both of them. And by the permission of Allah, ran, and the deer was running again. SubhanAllah. Yes, Quran, وَيُحْيِي الْمَوْتَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Ah, and he said, by the one, I swear, by the one who showed you this miracle, who take the 3rd piece of bread. He said, I did not take it. يَا بْنِي اللَّزِينَ. After seeing this miracle, and you still deny it. لَا حَوْلَ لَقُوتَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. He said, okay, come on. And they've been passing by the Jordanian River, Nahr al-Urdun, and they said, come with me. He said, what? Just give me your hand. And he took him, and they've been walking above the water. After they pass to another side, he said, but I swear by Allah to you, the one who showed you this miracle also, who took the last piece of bread. He said, I did not take it. Ya Magnoon, dunya, you're very greedy like that way? You hide that piece of bread from me? What kind of greedy person are you? And subhanAllah, when Sayyidina Isa, he knew, but Nabi, Allah gave him wisdom, knowledge. He said, I will fix you. Okay, I know you now. You're one of the followers of dunya. And they said, Sayyidina Isa, he make like a small, what they call a small, not hill. He of dirt. He make 3 of them. And they said, be gold, 3 of them. And Allah, by the permission of Allah, 3 pieces of gold, like heaps of gold, like a doctor, in front of him, he said, okay, this one for you, and this one for me. The 3rd one, for the one who take the third piece of bread. He said, I'm the one who take it. Aha, now I know you. He said, man, you're not my companion anymore. That's it. It's faraq bayna wa bayna. Take 3 of them. And Sayyidina Isa, he left. 3 thieves, they came, they saw the gold. I will repeat what Sheikh Kishki said. رأيت الناس قد ذهبوا إلى من عنده ذهبوا ومن لا عنده ذهب فعنه الناس قد ذهبوا. رأيت الناس منفضة إلى من عنده فضة ومن لا عنده فضة فعنه الناس منفضة. رأيت الناس قد مالوا إلى من عنده مال ومن لا عنده مال فعنه الناس قد مالوا. People loves the dunya so much. And the 3 thieves, they saw the gold, they executed him. One time, gold. They executed him. And they said, now we are close to the village. We need somebody to go to bring food and come very fast. We'll take the gold and we'll leave because somebody gonna come and see us. Shaitan is working now. People of dunya, subhanallah. The man said, go fast, don't wait. And the man, while he was going, he said, I'm gonna put poison in the food. I'm gonna poison the food to them. And they said, when he come, we're gonna kill him. We're gonna just share that gold with both of us. That's it. The man came, he was very tired. Since even he just came and they executed him. He was very tired, running. And subhanAllah, what happened? They said, let's eat some food, we are hungry. They've been eating the food. What happened to them? All of them died. Nobody touched the gold. Dunya like this. And Sayyidina Isa, when he came back, he saw his friend, his companion, and the three thieves dying, killing each other. And the gold is still in its spot. And Sayyidina Isa just was looking and crying like this. And he said, هَكَذَا الدُّنْيَا تَفْعَلُ بِأَهْلِهَا. This is how dunya will do with its people. If you run behind the dunya, this is your end. This is your end. Dunya matiya, like a female of a donkey. If you ride it, if you put it above your shoulder, people are going to say, الْمَجْنُونَ أو you're crazy. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us from the طلاب الآخرة. آمين يا رب العالمين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put الآخرة in our hearts, in our فؤاد, and to work for الآخرة. آمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل منا فإنك أنت السميع العليم واغفر فإنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. تب علينا يا ربنا فإنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. آمين.